when you deny your positives. This I have talked about all, right? Denying your, not accepting your negatives. You are not, I'm not good at this, I'm not this, I don't like this, I hate myself, I hate so many things, you know, whether it is physiology, whether it is thought, feelings and all. Then you deny your strengths. That is also lack of self-acceptance. When you deny your positives, when you deny your talent, when you deny your strengths, your positives, your talent, your strength, these are all things that help you now in your life. Am I denying what I am good at? No, I know now I have this talent in me. Am I even denying that I have the talent in me? As an example, suppose not, we say that somebody has to be a class leader. Many of you feel like I can be a class leader too. But then you don't even want to go there. No, you don't even want to say that yes, I want to be the class leader. You are denying that you can be that, but you are not going forward for that. Because somewhere now you feel like if I go there and if I mess up things, I know I have the talent. I know I am capable of doing it. If that person can be a class leader, I can be the class leader. But am I denying my strength? Am I denying now what I am good at? When you are denying what you are good at, how will you not overcome what you are bad at? You use your strengths not to overcome your weaknesses. And each of us has a lot of weaknesses in us. How do we overcome that? Use our strengths not to say, no, okay, let me do this, let me overcome this, let me feel better now in this area. Suppose tomorrow again we say now that there is going to be a program, how many of you can sing? You may be able to sing, you know you can sing well, but you come forward. Do you say, yeah, I can sing? How many of you jump and say, yeah, this is my talent, I can sing well, I can do this. The moment something is announced, everybody shrinks back, not wanting to go there, not wanting to say even what they have put it. Are you denying your positives? Denying your positives is not accepting yourself. You are saying, even if it is there, I am not prone to look at it. I am good at this, but I don't want to accept it in front of everybody that I am good at it. Right? Yes.
Is it like, if we boost our self-esteem, self-confidence comes naturally. It leads to...
The difference between confidence and self-esteem is, confidence is skill-oriented.
If it's talent or something, is it confidence or esteem?
No, that you have to decide now for yourself. Why are you denying that? You know, if it's an issue of confidence, confidence is, I may not be good at it. Confidence is specifically oriented towards a skill. The more you practice that skill, the better you become it. Self-esteem is a feeling. Right? Self-confidence is more like not, am I equipped for this or not? There's a difference between that. But if you can get the confidence to do that, you boost yourself. Right? Yes.
I just wanted to add, see, confidence, let's say I see this, I usually watch very less TV, but when I watch this Indian Idol, these kind of events, they come there with so much of confidence, but it is, I'm not using the right word, but they are very, very, very bad at singing. So they are bought there just to make fun of. You know, so overconfidence will lead to...
No, sometimes you can find people with a lot of confidence, but with the issue of self-esteem. It's not necessary that somebody who is extremely looking confident. No, don't go by appearances. Sometimes confidence is put on also. We can put on the confidence, but yeah, I can do these things. But internally, that person is not feeling good. And if they come with a thing like she said about talenting and failure rate, can you imagine what happens to the self-esteem? Millions of people are watching it now, then they're being made fun of. Yes,
my understanding is self-confidence is very high if my skills are good.
Exactly.
So if my skills are good, I have self-confidence.
Exactly.
And is it right to make a statement that if I have very high self-confidence, generally I have high self-esteem?
Not necessarily. Because confidence, like I said, it's skill oriented. Suppose now tomorrow I say, Nashri Vatsa, you are very good at public speaking. So your confidence when you come and stand on the stage is excellent.
It ends with that.
No,
but it ends
with that.
Some
players
may not be.
It ends with that. Confidence always comes from specifically. I am very confident of doing this. I am very confident of driving. You ask me to drive, I can drive. You ask me to speak in public, absolutely no confidence in speaking public. Because I don't have the skill. Confidence is connected to skill. Self-esteem is not connected to skill. Self-esteem is a much deeper issue than those in right? So if you have understood that denying the positives is clear about denying positives, what are the things that you deny for yourself, isn't it? You are good at something, you don't even want to acknowledge that. Somewhere you are suppressed now what you are good at, you have suppressed your strengths, then you are not accepting yourself. Right? So I just want to take 2 minutes and write down now, what are the things that you don't accept about yourself? Things that you don't accept yourself, and where do you use the word I hate something about?
about me, I hope it is not wrong.
You need hate to be a strong word, you need to dislike each other.
Right, enough for dislike. Today I dislike the people. Do you have an issue where you dislike something very strongly about yourself? About your thought, behavior, your spirituality, your sexuality, your whatever, nah, you deny.
Because hate word is loosely used.
Yeah, very
actually, I don't mean I hate, but I use the word hate.
Yeah, but I still wanted to write it down. You
I hate to do this. I hate.
That is different.
It is not hate.
Yeah, I understand. But I want to see if you really, dislike something very strongly about yourself. What is it that you dislike very strongly about yourself? What are the things now that you are good at which you deny yourself? Do you have an issue of self-acceptance?
Before you go to that point, I have one little doubt about self-acceptance. See, when you talked about hating your own body, your thoughts and your feelings.
Thoughts, feelings, behavior, sexuality, spirituality. Do I deny any of these things?
Okay. What about skills? Let's say I'm bad at using computers and I hate that.
It's a skill. It's about confidence. It's not about personality.
So, it will not affect your esteem.
Not affect your self-esteem. No, the lack of skill will affect your self-esteem. So, when we come to the issue of self-responsibility, it means like, do I own my life? Do I take responsibility for my thoughts? Do I take responsibility for my behavior? Or when you are talking to a person with low self-esteem, you will see that they are putting the blame for everything on others. You know, it is always, he makes me feel angry. Can somebody make you feel angry? I felt angry now because of what he did. That's the way you have to put the sentence, isn't it? It's not like he made me feel angry. Whenever he does that, he really makes me feel frustrated. He can't make you feel frustrated. You feel frustrated, right? If you are a person with better self-esteem, you always use the word I in connection to feelings. I own the feeling. This is mine, right? You have a dream. You have a goal to go. Do you expect others to fulfill that? Are you waiting for somebody else to take care of your goals? No, I have a dream, but I am waiting now. This person said he will come and do something for me, and then now I will achieve that. Are you abdicating your responsibility? Are you giving up your responsibility? The person with low self-esteem is going on giving the responsibility of everything in her or his life to others, including something like health. I am suffering from that. I have to go and get a medicine. He said he will get a medicine for me. Can't he go and do it? It's a comfort zone, then you kind of happy to be kind of giving away the responsibility to others. When you give responsibility of everything to your others in your life, you are going to have an issue of low self-esteem. You're not going to feel good about it now because you lack control in your life. The issue of self-esteem also comes like how much control do you have in your life? If you have a very low control in your life, you know, there are issues we can't deal with, fine. But is your area of influence bigger? Are you able to control many things in your life? Or are you saying that somebody has to fulfill my needs? Somebody has to fulfill my wants? Somebody has to look after my desires? Somebody has to fulfill my goals? When you are giving away all the responsibility to others or you are waiting for somebody to come and save you, then you have an issue of low self-responsibility, which leads to low self-esteem. Right? If you watch a counselor, if you hear a counselor talk, then you will hear this word, that you are supposed to do it. He said, nah, I can help you now with this, but he never did. There's no going forward and saying, I'm going to take the responsibility. Even the small thing, when it comes to self-responsibility, when people can make your counselor take responsibility for small things in their life, it boosts their self-esteem. A total lack of self-responsibility now is a disaster for self-esteem. They do not take responsibility for anything at all. No, if I have to do my parenting of my child, I'm expecting somebody else to come and take care of that. I'm not even saying I want to do this. No, my grandma, my mother-in-law said she'll take care of it, so I've left it to her. Can you step in? Can you come in and say, no, I want to do this? Can you own your life? Self-responsibility is all about owning your life. And also knowing that no one is coming. No one is coming to change your life. You want to change your life, you need to do it. You want to make the smallest change in your life, you need to take the action. There is no one, there is no miracle that is going to come. Self-responsibility also sometimes goes to such an extent that you abdicate everything to even a superhuman being. You know, like, he is there, he will take care of it. You know, he is there for some extent. You have to do the work now for him to help you. Right? If, in case you have a spiritual belief that somebody is going to take care of you need to do the work also. You can't sit idle and think now that he is going to help me to achieve my dreams. Right? Are you taking responsibility for your dreams? Are you taking responsibility for your goals? Are you taking ownership for your life? That's the bottom line part. Right? So can you write now? Do you have an issue now where you want to take more responsibility in your life? Which are the areas in your life that you would like to take a greater responsibility for yourself? Yes.
This also applicable in case of children, because when children is self-responsible, and they have adults who kind of decide everything for them.
No, again, it comes to the parenting style. Does the parent support not the child taking responsibility for themselves?
The child
would like to take the responsibility for herself in many areas where they can. Always look at it, it is not necessary for us to take responsibility for everything in our life. You know, we have something like this. No, we have an area of concern, then we have an area of influence. This is my influence area. This is my concern area. These are the issues that bother me. These whole issues bother me. These are the issues in which I have control over myself. Can I focus on this? In this area, I have control. If the child has got control over certain things, can he take responsibility for himself in that area? Not worry about this. Our focus is on this and misery is the result of it. Because there are so many things that are out of my control. Just because now I am saying you can take responsibility for everything doesn't mean I can take responsibility for things that don't belong to me. Right? Am I responsible for that? That's all you have to look at. Yes.
On the lighter side.
Yes.
Those who pay excessive visits to and to some extent temples, do you think they have low self-esteem?
Not necessary. See, one is like we derive a lot of people do derive a lot. Like all of us now, we are all leaning on something or another for our strength. Right? All of us need a crutch in our life. Like we are dependent on our relationships, we are dependent on our positions, we are dependent on our finances. Some people are dependent on their spirituality for strength. It doesn't indicate that. It indicates that only when they are completely given responsibility, they are doing nothing and sitting and saying, my life will be taken care of by somebody else. Life doesn't get taken care of by somebody else unless you take care of the basic thing. God, even if you believe in a God or whatever, He is going to help you now. He'll only create opportunities for you. Right? He's not going to come and lift you out of your misery or out of the room.
But I'm reminded, people understand that.
You need to understand that. I'll just give you a very interesting story that was there. Na. There was this village where it was announced that it was going to be, which was the river banks. Right? It was announced that there was going to be a huge flood in the river and the village is going to be drowned completely. Everybody started evacuating their houses saying, let us go away. There was this one man who decided that my God, he prayed to God and somehow he got the feeling that God said, I'll come and help you. I'll save your life, God said. So he said, God is saving my life. You people go, I don't want to come along with you. The floods came. The house got drowned not to the first ground floor. He went up to the first floor. The rescue boat came to say, come, let us all go. The villagers were still going away. He said, come, let's go. He said, no, you people go, God will save you. They went away. Then he went into the water, rose further. Then he went to the second floor of the house. He's standing on the terrace now, waiting now. The water has come to that level. Then the rescue boat again comes in now from some rescue team. And they say, it's over now, come, let's go. Otherwise, you people. He says, no, don't worry about it, you can go. God will save. God has told me He will save me, so He will save me. What do they do? They go away. Again the water rises, it goes up to the top of the water tank, which is the highest point in the house, and it stands there. Again now the last time now the rescue mission comes and says, we are not going to come again for you. This is the last time we can come. You are the only person left here. Why don't you jump into the boat? We'll take you from here. He says, you don't worry about it. You people are not at all, I'm not interested in you. God has told me that he will save you, so you don't worry about it, you go. So they also went away. The water rose further, it did drop and it died. Then he goes to heaven and looks at God fiercely angry. Nah? I'm very angry. I said, what happened? Why are you angry? He said, you told me you'll save me, but you didn't. He said, I said, people three times to save you. Nah? You didn't take the opportunity, what do I do? Right? So that's the thing, isn't it? You do take responsibility for it.
That is called blind faith.
It's blind faith. Nah? It may work or it may not work. But it affects your self-esteem. It undermines your self-esteem, nah? If you're not looking into it. So what we'll do is, I just wanted to divide into pairs of two and just discuss what I have discussed as a counselor counseling. 10 minutes each, we'll flip the roles, you'll get a chance to both be the counselor and the counseling. Just take your counseling through the issues that we discussed about self-esteem, about self-acceptance and about self-responsibility. Like many of you said, then can't come out and write whatever we have. Let us see if we can talk now about the issue to the counselor. Right?
Yeah, one small question before we So the area of responsibility is that inner circle.
Area of responsibility is inner. This is your area of influence. So you are concerned about many things in your life, about your job, not getting the rise, whatever you want or whatever. Can you affect that? This is the whole area of, always for us, the area of concern is very large in our life. The area of influence is very small in our life. If you focus on the area of influence, you expand this circle. If you are focused on this circle, you are ignoring this circle completely. You know, when you are ignoring this circle, your misery is going to rise. Isn't it? So when you take responsibility, it means now I am working here. I am working in my area of influence. What am I responsible for in my life? Can I take greater responsibility for things? Can I take greater responsibility for the upbringing of my children? Can I take greater responsibility for my finances? If the finances is issue is a bothering me, can I take greater responsibility for that now? And see to it that I am on a better level. Right? So can we quickly divide that?
Can I just ask this? I guess it's a problem with most housewives that of our society. That we always feel we have so much on our head, so much to do, that we don't take responsibility of ourselves.
Right.
We have no time to exercise, we have no time to see the doctor. Is this also something
like that? It is when you don't take responsibility. Is there a possibility to do it? Can you take responsibility for your body? You know, you need to be healthy. So that you go for a walk, can you find, can you do that a priority? Are you saying, nah, if my husband said he will also come for a walk, when he is going to come for a walk, I will go with him. It never happens, he doesn't come, your health is going on, it's getting deteriorated. Am I putting my happiness on others? When you say that my responsibility is somebody else to make me healthy.
But then you are saying that there is an issue of self-responsibility.
It affects your self-esteem. When your health goes on, it affects your self-esteem. Right? Can we quickly divide into pairs and discuss for 10 minutes each? When the 10 minutes is over,